So, Theater of Pain. Yeah, mostly this week. I've been in a few hires, so the there can be doable if everything just works. But as for now, I'm just chilling around on plus 7. As it's plus 7 for me drops 200 level loots, and that's not so bad. That's like 16 upgrades on all the pieces, even more for the blue ones. So in my head, if I get up many of these loots, be stronger and can make higher content. And yeah, of course I want to deal with the plague,
Five,
what's it called?
four,
Proudful
three,
ability
two,
in
one.
the plus tens. Time will tell. See how this one is. Three paladins too. Really good in this dungeon as there's so many poison or sick toxins mobs. I'm trying to use something. You have me? Would be grand to save some CDs at least for next pack. Okay, mobs is all. General didn't take all. 37 minutes, that's doable. Should be. Long dungeon though. Obviously with this timer, some dungeons are actually longer. Even though this one have 5 bosses. I know, didn't made any route for this yet. As pretty straightforward, like Centralis. Obviously there will be some mobs here and there you are able to skip. We'll see what happens. Oh, that's too bad. Fuck, here we go.
Spectral transference. Slam. One death. Mortal strike.
Want to kill that guy first? Instead of all the interrupts. That's a new one. Obviously they should know.
Genetic alteration. Searing death. Spectral transference.
Idiot. Lock stuff.
Slam. Mortal strike. Slam.
And also, yeah, as you know, I'm not as pro.
Slam.
Will take a while until I reach that 15. Obviously I'll do my best to at least get one up. To show it's doable. Don't think I survive much here though. Healers I see, they can go really higher with lower item levels. I'm 184 and I struggle like in plus 8s, plus 9s. So 7, guess it's the sweet spot for me until I get more loots. I really won't take that guy for the cleave. Really don't know if it's worth it. The Divine Thrall works so much better in mythic classes though. As it has 1 minute cooldown. I don't say it's up for every pack, but very many packs. was that? Ow. Okay, defensive only does that. That seems like a lot of effort. Dungeon achievements is like in the end when you're bored of the content. I hope there's better than this one in BFA though. I really disagree that you needed all professions to make certain achievements. Like tailoring, engineering, mining and everything to spawn the mobs to get the achievement. Pretty annoying in 5-man group when everybody didn't add all the abilities. Well, real friendly group though, real achievement hunters then went out and switch professions just to do it. As you obviously didn't need a certain level. That's pretty cool. Okay, headshot. And yeah, if you haven't seen the new dungeon system, I think it's good for the players that run high content. As those who are not really there yet aren't able to run that because they can't do the high level. If you see here, shit, don't die. Current is my key, but complete the dungeons, you see. 3 more mythics for 1 more loot in the chest to be able to choose from. But then again, still, the item level of this reward will be based on the lowest of your top 10 key keys. And my lowest is a plus 5. So it doesn't matter if I run a plus 20. I will still get plus 5 loots. So rip old school weekly chest thingy. When you can do like only 115 and you have your weekly. Will help your friends if you're not at that content. That obviously doesn't work anymore. Because it's based on your lowest dungeon. So if you go with another friend and help him with a plus 2. You will get up a weekly with plus 2 loots. Not total sure yet, we'll see it weekly, because they said there will be 3 items to choose from. Hopefully some of them will be higher. But obviously mine is based on plus 5. That's my lowest standard. I guess it's a good thing overall, cause boosting in lures will not be as good for yourself, as you will end up with lure items in your weekly if you decide to go lure dungeons. Don't know if it's just 1 or 2 of them all 3 of the first one. Time with tell. Oh, Wednesday when we open the chest, obviously. When we have all the facts. Yeah, pretty much straightforward this dungeon. Don't know. Maybe can Shroud skip some parts if we overpresent it somewhere.
Brutal combo. Oppressive banner. Deafening crash. Massive cleave.
Yeah, this boss is self-explaining. I'm not sure if I can keep that with one hour though, because I haven't figured out if the heal or not, but they reduce mobility. But free roam doesn't really matter. I don't know what more they do. And those two players that get down there have to PvP each other to get back up. When I did this with my friends, I didn't even bother to shoot them. I just stand with my back against them to make them kill me fast. So you get back up here fast. Don't know if you get buff or anything, but it worked fast at least. Where the fuck is his corpse? Oppressive banner. Brutal combo. I can't see it.
Massive cleave. Crushing slam. Deafening crash.
Come here.
Oppressive banner. Brutal combo.
God damn, that was late.
Blood and glory. Deafening crash.
Risky.
Massive cleave. Massive cleave.
Totally worth having a combat rest though. And yeah, this is me. I use this new Shadowland combat rest. Don't need a high level to get it, 60 or 70 or something. And in places like this, totally worth it if no one at my warlock have computer summon model. But if you end up lucky in groups, someone dies, and you have the time over the computers, then pretty neat. To not have to restart or have hard time or wipe or stuff like that. Please, left way. Three paladins. Yeah, I don't pull the room here, fuck that shit. Think we should be able to hit the timer though. Even. It's a bit weird with the dodger. The other thing I did was 42, and listen, this is only 37. Obviously, this is a shorter dodger. Well, same BFA. When they added the new affixes and raised the scaling, they increased timer as well. I remember King's Rest and. Was it Shrine as well or something? Can't recall. To even it out. Healer, dispel you. Yeah, this one you can go around to skip. Cause there's the entrance and there's the exit, and we when he is back here, can totally just pass him without him see you. as the mob stuff. Still fortified. Still really low content. But yeah. We all go through this every now and then. And that's the wrong way. I'm a moron. Is what I usually said when I found a new friend or new incomers to the game, like we all been here. Obviously, those one who play a longer time able to handle all stuff and things more. Don't say flawless though, but they used too much. But the new players, they. Can be good to give a heads up. Cause we all build new. It's much thing I have no clue of. But yeah, some groups you learning and really appreciate that. Pro tip that it comes. I know I have it. I used to use it on the healer. Obviously now we have a paladin healer, really good for this dungeon. Shit, standing and shit. Like a moron. But if you go with this dungeon without any paladin that can dispel that shit, you can end up in the deep shit. Yeah, totally closer to where though. I was trying to run down and pick up the mods. Yeah, this is a waste of time. Voice for the win, because this reduces so much time standing and writing stuff. So much HP, man. Three more bosses. We used more than half the time. Well, we have 70% forces though. So that's pretty neat. And I look stupid. Like a Pepega. Well, I ain't judging anyone of that except myself. That's bad gameplay. Boss time! Really don't want to get hit by the hooks this time. That's pretty useless. They hurt much. The mythic zero. In my head, they hurt even more here.
Hateful strike. New pets. Tenderizing smash.
Wow. I got my hit rate. Fucking Pepega. I thought that was on the edge to pass the second one. That was so bad, man.
Tenderizing smash. Hateful strike. Tenderizing smash. Meat hook.
Well, as long as the stuff and things doesn't go faster.
Hateful strike.
It's a pretty chill boss. And yeah, no, I'm not allowed to say that as I got hit by the fucking Mythox, but still. It's not super complicated. Like some bosses can be.
Save me?
Huh, thank you. Oh, we have the other area as well. Well, I just hope to get back the timer. I have so many deads too. When you get the amount, you have like 0 to 3 deads with combaters or something. Then you can go for a few higher levels, I guess. I really don't know why I bought so much the time though, but obviously I mostly for the video. You will still get the loot. Got them here. Does he still know the leaves hit on the ground? Or won't they follow? This must be pretty shitty bullshit. Well, the same eye level, so maybe not a big issue. Yeah, that was pretty much more shield than to fight them outside in the AoE area, I guess. Need to recover? Nah, we're fine. Wow, how did I almost fall down there? Almost made a joy, fun times. Yeah, I'm not using this much. Don't have any single tower to brag about. So I saved the killer ability brat for the next cheater pack. Those with mid guy middle and the small at the sides that see it stuns and interrupts and shit. Where's the ball? This would be interesting to see if someone managed to get knocked down. That usually happens. 2 of 3 runs, no yuke. Yeah, this one can be good. It's not really hard trash yet. But any interrupts can be a really good time here. And yeah, interrupt and walk away from the big ass AoE and it should be fine. Hopefully. Easy. Didn't use that. Didn't have to use that much CDs. Wow, killed that screen. Now, knockback platform. Is it? No, it isn't. One more. Then come the fun parts. That's very fine if you just shield them, I guess. Last boss should be pretty fast though. And not the last to... last in this area. That before boss. And from that until the last one is zero trash, so I guess we'll be fine. Over forces though. So we have to check the replay that. If we can manage to skip somewhere. Came pretty neat. One bites the dust, yeah. It's the big guy, he makes this black tornado. If you get hit by it, obviously you die before you get knocked back sometimes. Imagine that in really high keys. You don't want to touch that one. Why do I run with the chat weapon? Won't say it normal, but that's normal. Almost me, shit. Imagine me dying there, it'd be so much fun. That's pretty much the tactics here, and spread, don't stand on top of each other. See if I can try to mark it though. A circle! Wow, did I miss that one? Thanks, this boss is pretty chill. Surely the players that can summon them odds and make the hunt group. That's pretty shit, cause they can hurt them much if they don't collect them fast. But yeah, for tanks you just stand here, attack the big guy. And if they know the tactics, you don't even have to explain anything. You just stand here, attack the big guy, wait for it to die. Pretty chill boss, to be fair. Well, so far, we haven't met it yet in plus 20 Tyrannical, if that's ever gonna happen. But yeah, don't know if the healer can, probably can, and all the DPSs to stand in the circle, they can get like a 3 seconds of CC the ghost to see. They don't run, and they can collect it right away. And if they don't stand in the ring, the ghost runs from them, spectral and they need to be fast to collect them. But yeah, like this, when everybody tic-tacs, it's pretty easy. 7 minutes! Guess this will be the now or never pool. Yeah, this is where Mythic Zero at least, in my opinion, hardest boss fights in all the dungeons. Obviously now we have more DPS, but still the dungeon is higher. So he does this beam, so frontal, not moving, don't stand in it. We have our rift coming, if you get sucked into that shit, you get CC'd. Then you want to go to a certain place, and stack loosely. Just to kill the birds first. Because they stand in there like idiots and cast things on you. Oh, like I said, where is he? Grasping rift. Manifest death. Reaping sight. I need to move so I can see him. Echo of battle. Bad positioning. Really bad. Where the fuck is the warlock? Can't even use anything now. Dark devastation. Reaping sight. Grasping rift. Echo of battle. Can't use anything.
Ghostly charge. Reaping sight. Dark devastation.
Come on.
Manifest death. Echo of battle.
Shit. Huh. Well, that's pretty useless combo with their sand when everybody's dead. Spawn already.
Reaping sight. Dark devastation.
Beam.
Grasping rift. Manifest death. Reaping
away from rift. Feels good. Stack loosely. Cleave them odds, kill them fast.
Dark devastation.
Beam.
Echoes of carnage.
Yeah, imagine to blood pop Lallas at this face. That would be fucking awesome. Get this shit port down fast. I want 20 more seconds though so I can have my bubble up. That'd be amazing!
Grasping Rift. Manifest Death. Reaping Sight.
Do you see me one more time?
Yes, AoE taunt here. Yes, to survive, but also pick up the buds.
Reaping Sight. Grasping Rift. Echo of Battle.
Can we just kill the boss in 50 seconds so we can win? Well, no blast needed, at least. Interest. Okay. Give me them loots. Ooh. Conduct. What's this? What's this? What more did I get? A ring? Really? That's so nice. I want my mastery so good. I want the crit either. I just put this as an upgrade because you see, stress priority crit, even if it's least priority stats, it still gives you parry and you survive better. And yeah, I didn't make a route for this Theater of Pain yet. It's pretty much straightforward, but yeah, when you go down below, don't know if the sea is tilted, but maybe you can skip a pack of this if you're a foster or anything. Well, at least Theater of Pain up, give it a try and see you by soon!